Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst and Atari. We are here in Icewind Traders, and today we will be reading The Magic of Dusk, which I found in Castle Bruma. The Magic of Dusk, the original work by Casta Scribonia. Editor's note: this work, partially spared by the rats and the humidity, is all that is left of the notes from one of Casta Scribonia's numerous works. She was a popular and prolific author, active in the last years of the Third Era. However, her writings were often poorly received, likely because of the frivolous subjects she was dearly devoted to. In a personal note, author Alicia Otis once referred to her books as the most ridiculous example of ill-earned success since Crassius Curio. Although this book was left unpublished, it seems Scribonia had high hopes for her new literary feat, as a footnote clearly discloses. The full work, painstakingly completed by Green Emperor Publishing, will soon go on sale at all official outlets. Chapter 7. And once again Fair Mabel waited, deep in the woods of Calovia, eager to be wrapped by the arms of the night. The last rays of the sun vanished in the embrace of the trees, as a hue of fiery red, replacing the daylight, reminded her of her lover. She shivered in anticipation. It was nearly time. The stunning vampire lord was like a pale ghost against the dark trunks. His ebony hair was a vision of bliss to Mabel. She moved a few hasty steps, lost in the rapture of love, before abandoning herself to his arms. "Jacobus," she whispered, "you are like magic to my soul, the magic of dust, ephemeral, unique. Never, not even in the sweetest of my tales, would I have dreamed of someone like you." "We went through this, love," he said, watching the horizon in deep melancholy. "My clan must not find out, and believe me, they will. And yet, oh, your skin, your tender hands, beautifully shaped by the burden of the quill. How could I leave you? Ever. How could I break this spell?" "You do not need to, sweetest of creatures," she cried, biting her full lip in deep anguish. "I don't want you to keep far from me any more." "Lipsand Tarn, where my home is," Jacobus said. "Stay away. They might ask." Missing page. His noble spirit. "I am dangerous," he insisted. "I could kill you faster than a mountain lion. Tear your tender skin. You make me so hungry, actually," he murmured in her ear. "You do make me feel like a lion." Charmed, the beautiful lady turned to his face, caressing his cheek sweetly. He was cold as death, but she could not care less. He gazed in her clear blue eyes, lady of his heart. "Fear not, dearest Jacobus. Do not leave me, my beloved. I am not afraid of what you are. I never was. Curse the envious souls, and make me one of you. Our love will know no boundaries, and together we will write the most wondrous of tales." "I can't." "You know you can, dearest. Did I ever tell you how marvelous?" "No, when Master glimmers so pure, your skin has a shine of Magnus itself." Footnote: this one will sell a lot. I feel it inside. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, The Magic of Dusk.